まあ、この場所ですけど、ここが村役場です。
So on the right, this is the village hall.
隣が本屋さん。
And next door is the
本屋さん。
The bookshop.
こちらが、特別養護老人ホーム。
And on the left, it's an aged care facility.
で、ここは震災後も避難をせずにずっとここで続けています。
And that's been continued, so the elderly people living there, they were not actually evacuated, they were able to stay here and it's being there.
これは避難によって、お年寄りを移動するというリスクを避けるためにここで営業を続けました。
And the reason for that is because of the elderly people being in a very vulnerable state, actually the evacuation process or you know, living in evacuation in these kind of circumstances would be more damaging to their health as well, so they are still operating that aged care facility and they are still living there.
役場も、4月1日、今日から、大まかな部署が戻って、この稼働をここで始めてます。
ちょっと今日はですね、時間も限られているので、私の方で思いつくところを、まあ、ご案内してふさわしいかどうかはあれですけども、飯舘村がですね、非常に線量の高いと言われているこの地区ですね、長泥地区っていうんですけど、ここだけはもう住民は戻れないというふうに判定されている地域です。そこに実はゲートがありまして立ち入りできないんですね。それから
And so we'll spend the morning today here in Itate.The various different parts of the village, of course, you know, we don't have time to see everywhere, so Mr. Ito will guide us to a few different places. But the part in the lower area where he was showing on the map, which is known as the Nagadoro area of Itate, that's where the radiation levels are particularly high, and it's thought that it will not be possible for people to return to live there. There's also barricades there, so you're not able to, enter that area as well.
あと一箇所はですね、まあ、これも大したあれではないんですが、結局そのばらまかれたセシウムを回収する、あるいはセシウムに汚染したものの処理の場所としてですね、この蕨平に、日量240トンの焼却炉があります。原油化施設っていう、容量を減らすという意味なんですけども、まあ、そこをご案内します。
And there's also one area here in what's called the Warabidaira area, in the lower part there as well. And there is actually a facility there, which it's kind of an incinerator facility, but it's actually for all of the materials, the cesium or also the cesium contaminated items and so on. It's made to actually sort of compress them or make them smaller and so on for after storage. So that's in that area of the village as well.
あとはですね、道中見ていただくと分かるんですが、黒い、まあ、今いらっしゃるところ時ももうご覧になったと思うんですが、黒い袋にですね、砂を入れて山積みにしてあります。
And also of course as you've seen as you're coming into the village as well on both sides of the roads as well, but these large black bags with the sand and soil and everything compiled inside.
で、除染っていう、まあ、セシウムを取り去るつもりなんですが、農地とか宅地のですね、表面5センチの土を削り取って、そのバッグに入れてます。
And so the decontamination is supposedly, you know, being conducted for the purpose of removing the cesium, the radioactive materials. However, what's being done there is the top 5 centimeters of the soil is being taken off. So it's the 5 centimeters, just the top layer there.
で、5センチ取りましたから、5センチ土をかぶせるという作業が必要なんですね。で、実はこれ外出ていただいてご覧いただくと分かるんですが、この山が一つ消えました。山を崩して砂を取っていくという。
And so because they're removing that top 5 centimeter layer, well, there needs to be something, you know, put back on to re-level it again as well. So if you look over here, you can see actually the first hill, all of the soil has been removed from the mountain there. So it's getting kind of bald there. You can see that's where the soil is being taken to have put that back as well.
一割前になります。 私どもが2012年の5月にですね、アンケートを取ったんですが、その時はですね、50% の人が帰らない、それから、21% の人が、帰れない、要するに、年間被曝量1ミリを、という基準に引っかかってですね、帰られる。ちょっと7割の人は帰らないか帰れないんですね。そうすると3割、まあ、1800人帰ってくるかどうか、まあ、2000人なのかなと思うんですけど、現時点で村がそういうことをアンケートの面接をして確認するということもしていないんです。基本的にはここが人、ここにですね、人が住むにふさわしい場所かって言ったら全くそうではない。年間被曝量1ミリシーベルトっていうのが確実に超えます。でそんなところにですね、お年寄りといえども返していいのかっていうのが、まあ、私が常々言ってることなんですが、ただ一方ですね、仮設住宅での生活のストレスがすごいもの
And so when you look at the radiation levels around here and you think about, well, is this a place that's suitable for people to live again? Of course, there's this very good question, and it's clear that the annual dosage here would exceed, you know, 1 millisievert per year. And so thinking in that way, you know, whether even elderly people should be allowed to live here, that's a big question. But at the same time, the stress on elderly people living in the temporary housing as well is very, very serious too. So when you try and, you know, balance that on two sides of the scale, it's a really difficult decision to think about.
道路の脇を見ていただくとですね、薄緑の、まあ、吹きの塔っていうんですが、植物がたくさん今この時期出ています。でそれがですね、住民にとっては、食料の一つ、まあ、嗜好品だったんですね。それが今測ってみますと、まあ、1キロあたり300とか400ベクレル出てくるという環境です。
And on each side of the road you'll see a lot of mountain plants growing. One of the small green sort of sprouts you can see, it's actually a mountain vegetable called fukino to. I don't think it has an English name, but it's sort of a mountain root vegetable andIt was one of the main things that, you know, the local residents would really enjoy eating, especially at this season when they're really growing. However, when you monitor or measure the radiation levels in them now, it's about 300 to 400 becquerels per hour.